started painting about 1998, maybe a little bit before then, because I have a grandson that was staying with me at the time, and he was my little buddy. And so one day we were right here in this room, and he said, "I can't do anything." I said, "Oh, yes, you can." I said, "What do you want to do?" He said, "I think I want to draw." I said, "You do?" I said, "Okay." So I went back there and I got a piece of paper and got some crayons, and wasn't much stuff in here then. So I put the paper on the floor and he got on the floor. He was about, I guess, about 5 or 6. Got on the floor and I said, "What do you want to do?" And he said, "I want to draw Mr. Brown." Mr. Brown was our neighbor, and that was his best friend. And that's how I started painting. I was doodling right along with my little friend. And I just kept
on going,
and, you know. And when I introduce myself to children, I say, "I paint like you. My little people look a lot like your little people because they are stick images. I just put some clothes on them, because underneath every piece that I do, the little bodies are naked, and I put my paint on top of them, or I put fabric or paper on top of them. Just simple as that." This is one of my favorite pieces because it gives me a background on where I come from as high school, Plato Price High School, which is no longer in existence, and those people who were instrumental in my education at a very early age. And there are persons there who are a part of who I am
this
today.
This picture has the white children in the background on the bus going that way, and my friends are going this way, because, and we're separated with this fence because we were segregated. And that's kind of how I saw it. We were separated, although we are going to do the same thing. My friends are going to school, and the other children of the white race are going the opposite way, going to school.
For sure. You had said that one was a more difficult, or took
some extra
time to paint.
Well, it's difficult because when we would get to school, some of the children would talk about what had happened to them on the way to school. Sometimes the children would throw things at them. Or the bus would go by real fast, and they would come to school, and their socks would be wet because the water would splash on them. There was no regards to the little people walking to school, because it was kind of hard sometimes to walk to school. You know, they may take a dog and let the dog get you, or anything could happen to you on the way to school. You always walked in a group, because you didn't want to be out there alone. It was safer to be with somebody than it was to walk alone.
What would you recommend just to people about life? Like, I mean, it had things, obviously some things have changed now, but maybe some things haven't changed. Mm-hmm, I don't know. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. How do you think people should just treat people? People treating people.
Always,
that's a loaded question, I know. But
always recognize that your neighbor or the person that you are around is a human being, and know that they laugh, they cry, they bleed just like you do. Mm-hmm. And always understand that, and then within yourself, if you understand that that's what that person can do, regardless to the color of their skin or the texture of their hair, they cry, they laugh, and they can be happy just like you can. And if you look at that in a wider, more sophisticated scope, then you won't feel like you want to harm or just be mean to them just because they don't look the same way that you do. Remember that they laugh, they cry, and they bleed.
Well, when I was a child, my father had cotton, and that was in the Oakdale area. And when you look across the field, everybody's backs would be bent over early in the morning to late in the evening. And they look like humps. You know, to a child, it looks like humps out there. And of course, people didn't always wear lots of colors in the field, because wearing certain colors, you get too hot. But I felt the need to put the color to it, because you would hear the sounds of humming and laughter out in the field among the people, and joke telling out in the field as they were.
As you've been sharing. So what I learned today, folk art, kind of by definition, is non-formal training and so forth, just kind of picking it up and going for it.
How it comes out.
And you had also said something about art and music and everything is life, right?
Yeah.
So I believe there's probably a lot of other people that may have those same thoughts as well. People who have a desire for painting or a desire for some sort of art form, but maybe don't have formal training. Would any advice that you would give to somebody who may watch this video and say, I'd love to pick up a paintbrush, or I'd love to continue and do more paintings, or...
Pick up anything they want to pick up. They can pick up paintbrush, they can pick up pencils, they can pick up crayons, anything. And do it for yourself. That's how I started. I never thought that anybody would ever want to buy a piece of my work, because I gave away lots of it when I first started, because I did not know that I was going to be taken this far. So I think that just do it. Just do what you feel you want to do. And that's how I usually start a class, is say whatever you feel inside. If it's a dot, make a dot. Just do it. And make yourself feel good about it. You like it. I like it. Because lots of times I'll do a piece and no one else like it but me. If I'm doing what I want to do, I work on it until I've finished it, whether it be that day or the next day. Sometimes, like this piece I started last year, and I was working on it for myself, and someone called from Vermont and said, I want a piece of your work. I said, well, I'm working on a piece for myself. He said, well, I want it. I said, come on. He said, yeah, I want that piece, because if you like it, I want it. So he started paying on it before he has not even seen it.
And anything so, that Nellie Ashford wants to say to people?
To people, I'd like to say that I'm honored when someone recognizes my work and just say they like it, or even enough to buy it. I'm even more honored. I'm such a folk artist that I never knew that it was going to take me this far, that I'm just always just feel so grateful that a person comes up and say, I would like to purchase a piece of your work. If you feel that good about my work, I'm just honored. You know, I'm humbly honored. My name is Nellie Ashford. My dream is possible. Thank you. Thank you.